didn't have enough to worry about. New research claims the Earth's inner core has stopped spinning. And now some scientists believe it could even reverse direction within the next decade.
If you believe the headlines, it would seem the Earth's core has stopped, paused, reversed direction, or some combination of the above. This might lead you to ask,
are we doomed?
Well, it certainly seems so if you watch the news reports or you scroll through these headlines. They are certainly fodder for panic. But what's interesting is that in 2003, there was already a reference to the core stopping in an aptly titled movie, The Core.
The core of the Earth has stopped spinning. The spinning core protects us from cosmic radiation. Without it, radiation will create superstorms. Microwaves will literally cook our planet.
Well, of course, that was science fiction, and the news reports are not science fiction, right? By now, you've probably gathered that the answer to did the Earth's core stop or reverse is a no, albeit a qualified no.
What you talking about, Willis?
Sadly, we can't take the news reports at face value. Science itself can be flawed, journal articles may not present findings clearly, and then you have the press releases, which are another degree removed from the science. And finally, the media gets a hold of things, and what started out as a chicken sighting turns into a story about a really big carnivorous dinosaur.
Morning, Ginger. Back from holiday?
I wasn't on holiday, Babs. I was in solitary confinement.
Oh.
Oh!
In the case of this head or core spinning story, the problem was the same. Poor understanding coupled with hyperbole. I'll assume it was mainly poor understanding. Part of the fault was in the reporters not grasping the basic science. But the scientists were to blame as well. More on this in a minute. First, let's start with the media.
Have we ever dug to the middle of the inner core?
No, not even close.
Do we want to?
No.
What would happen if we did?
Well, it's pretty dangerous as you go down. It gets hotter and hotter.
So no, we can't just dig down and have a little look-see at what's going on in a 9,000 degree oven. Not to mention there's miles of crust and mantle totaling over 1,800 miles to the center of the Earth. Humans have only dug as deep as 7 to 8 miles.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the center of the Earth.
As we can't get to the center of the Earth, we need to rely on indirect means by which to make inferences. Typically, this involves observing seismic waves known as P and S waves. The three most important facts about these waves are, 1. P waves are faster than S waves, 2. S waves can't travel through liquids, and 3. Wave speed depends on the density of what they travel through. From these principles, we were able to infer the presence of the mantle, liquid core, and solid core by observing how waves travel through or get bent as they travel from one side of the Earth to the other. Now, back to the sensational headlines. According to a Nature Geoscience article published in January 2023, the inner core was supposedly stopping or reversing. What the authors meant was that the core was spinning slower or appeared to be stopping or reversing compared to the mantle. The key fact is that the core and the mantle are not spinning together, but independently of each other. One can theoretically speed up while the other slows down and vice versa. So when the scientists said pause or reverse, they meant that relative to an observer on the surface, the core slowing down would appear to be pausing or reversing. The best way to picture this is to imagine a car driving alongside you on a freeway in the same direction. If the car slowed down a bit and you started to pull away, it would appear the other car had stopped. If the car suddenly slowed down a whole lot, it would appear to you as if it suddenly went in reverse. Another way to imagine it is to think of Clark Kent running next to a train. But the nuances of the science were lost in translation, and the journal article itself contained misleading statements such as, the inner core has nearly ceased its rotation and may be experiencing a turning back. What the researchers meant to say was that the inner core was slowing down so much that it looks like it's turning back. Had they put it this way, they wouldn't have had to print corrections to the original article, such as turning back of the inner core relative to the mantle. While this is clearer, it could be even clearer if they simply said slowing down instead of turning back. So wait, that still begs the question, why is the inner core slowing down at all? Well, according to the researchers, we don't know. Just that it happens approximately every 70 years, or at least that's their best guess. Another study suggested that speed changes happen every 6 years. But again, the cause and consequences are still unknown. A truly staggering headline would be something like, "The Earth may stop spinning for 3 seconds tomorrow." While at first blush, you might think that's just going to add 3 seconds to my lunch break. The implications, though, are actually catastrophic. Since the Earth spins at about 1,000 miles an hour, everything connected to the Earth, including the atmosphere, is spinning at that speed as well. So picture yourself on a merry-go-round. You're not moving relative to the merry-go-round, but you are moving. So if the merry-go-round suddenly stopped, you would keep going, flying off at whatever speed the merry-go-round was spinning. If the Earth stopped suddenly, you, along with very large buildings, would fly to the east at 1,000 miles per hour. This would also be known as Doomsday, which is the topic of this next video, which will tell you all about the actual times the world was close to total annihilation. Hint, it had nothing to do with the inner core.